So a new episode of Founder in Car, and today we will discuss DRIP. And DRIP stands for Dividend Reinvestment Plan. So what does that mean? If you have Tesla making all these beeps because it's quite narrow here. But normally you have an investment, for example stocks, into a company, and if that company makes profit, oftentimes they also pay out dividend. So dividend you can see as like a return on investment next to the value growth the company can make. But if you look at dividend, dividend is like the eggs a chicken produces. So for example, you bought a part of the chicken, 10% of the chicken, so 10% of those eggs are also for you, then in this case. And with a DRIP, so Dividend Reinvestment Plan, abbreviated, you get that dividend and you reinvest that. And a dividend reinvested can be in the same chicken. So for example, you have 10% of the chicken in my example, and you also get 10% of the eggs, and those eggs are a certain value. For example, the chicken is worth 100 euro, so you invested 10 euro in the chicken, and then you get the eggs, and the eggs can be daily, for example, in my example. But normally dividend is paid out once a year, or once a quarter, or once a month, depends on the strategy that they use. But for example, if we take those eggs that you get once a month, so to say, and the value of those eggs could be like 50 euro. So if that's 50 euro, you get 10% of that, that's 5 euros. So, and you reinvest that in another chicken, then you have 5% of one chicken and 10% of the other. Or if you reinvest it in the same chicken, you would have, instead of 10%, 15% of that chicken the next month. So the next month, again, you get the eggs that are of a certain value. In this case, the eggs are still the value of 50 euros of that month. And you get 15% of that 50 euros. So you, instead of getting 5 euro, you get 7.50 euro. And that is reinvested again into the chicken. And now you have, instead of the 10% you started with, 22.5%. And then the next month you get 50 euros, and you get 22.5% of that. So that's the principle around DRIP. And the benefit is that if you have a strategy, a buy and hold strategy, this is, so sometimes people buy stocks and just for the value growth and then resell them once they have reached a certain value growth, and then buy others or the same stocks again. But with a DRIP, if you keep these shares that pay dividend for a longer period of time, you can have value upon value. So if you would compare it with a normal saving accounts, it would be rent upon rent. So the rent that you get, the return on investment, in this case a dividend, is also invested again, so it can get you additional dividend, like rent upon rent. If you have rent, if you get a percentage of the money that you invest in opportunity A, B, or C, or on your saving accounts, and you reinvest that, you can also get rent or a percentage of that value on the reinvested money that you received from rent in the earlier phase. And this DRIP type of reasoning can, depending of course on how much the value is of those dividends, can double the returns over a longer period of time. But of course, there's also a thing that you should take into consideration. You will not be getting those eggs to eat for yourself at this time. But of course, the benefit with a drip is that you still can plan to take out a part of the dividend for yourself, for example, and reinvest the other part. So there are some mixes to be made. And of course, if you're not in need of the extra income, you can make the extra income in the future to be even bigger. And that's the entirety of this planning, so to say. Well, almost there. It's a little bit different this time. I hope you like these videos. If you do, please let me know in the comments. And also feel free to subscribe. I made a different playlist that's named Founder in Car, so you will find many a video that has similar beneficial attributes as this video. Please check it out. Have a great day. Bye bye. So another Founder in Car series, and today we're going to discuss why you should follow through. What I mean with this is many people start something, or want to start something, sometimes that's even worse, and they don't follow through. And if you don't follow through, you will never know what that thought that you had, that project, could mean for you. And of course, there is a reason that not following through could be a good thing. If you get insights that things are not as you expected them, so it would be stupid to follow through on something that isn't working. But on the other hand, I think also in friendships and relationships and also in business, it's not always roses and moonshine. Sometimes it's also, we say roze en maneschijn in Dutch, so perhaps this is a little bit double Dutch, but sometimes also hard work and not that pleasant, but it's all in the game. And if you're not following through, also in relationships or business relationships, you are not responsible at your side and you cannot be trusted. And so that will also damage your relationship with your customers or your fellow entrepreneurs, and all the other things in your life as well. Plus, by following through, also when the going gets tough, you will build additional resilience in your mind, your mental resilience, and you will know and grow from that experience. So I rather have you following through when you make an agreement, and even if it's a bad thing for you, and then don't do it the next time because you've learned from it, than to just say, yeah, we did agree upon that, but we do it another way now because it this simple isn't working for me. That's of course a way to go, but that will damage the relationship and also your own sense, because once things are getting tough, you will quit. And the thing is, in this example, it might be a little bit of a choice. For me, it would not be a choice because you make an arrangement and then you should stick with it. That's my personal belief. But there will be times in your life that things are not a choice. You will be forced to do so and to follow through or die, for example, or just get into big trouble. And you need that mental resilience also in your mind. And to know that even if the going gets tough, you keep going on, you keep moving forward. And that's an important lesson to learn, and also for your relationships. So for example, if you have a plan and it doesn't work out, but your fellow entrepreneurs, your partners see that you do what it takes, even if it's not working for you, you will gain enormous respect if you have the right persons surrounding you. Of course, there always can be persons that are just there for the taking and to gain access and to see you as someone that they can exploit. It could be a different story. But if you have the right persons around you, they will respect you. And even those that want to exploit you, they will respect that you have a good heart, that you are a hard worker. And if you work hard, even the things that are not working out at the moment can grow into something beautiful. So that's an important lesson that I wanted to convey today about following through. And I hope that I hear something from you, what your thoughts are on the topic, and if you think that this is a wise decision or an unwise decision and why. For me, I believe in long-term relationships, and therefore I believe in win-win situations. So sometimes you will gain something with your, as compared to your partner, and the other times you will be giving a lot more. But that is not that important. You know that you can rely on each other, and that's the most important thing. Even if the thing isn't working out, you know that the relationship and the partnership between the two of you or more is working out, and that's the important part. Have a great day. Bye-bye.